very delighted to be here to share with you the joy and success of our senior school play. And so, on behalf of our students and staff at VENICE, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you all. Our school is a hub of activities and a place where we learn a whole gamut of subjects that include the most serious ones like science and math to the ones that we learn while we simply practice them like art and sports. The school year 2018-19 has indeed been a roller coaster ride just like all the previous years. A time full of opportunities, a time full of learning, and time well spent. Learning and enjoying with friends all at the same time. Being competitive at some times and a helping hand at others. It indeed has been a glorious period just like every school year at VENICE. You will all appreciate what all we have accomplished this last 1 year. In 2018, our seventh O-level batch of 16 students graduated with 9 A stars and 36 A's and have attained admission in the top A-level schools of Karachi. The feedback that I receive from the management of these A-level schools is that our students stand out, in particular with their conduct, grooming, and manners. This is a huge achievement and a proud moment for us and reinforces our belief that strength does not lie in numbers but in quality. Instilling values is as important, if not more, as achieving grades. In 2018, VENICE was the only school from Pakistan to participate at the International Model United Nations held in Jordan, where our team of 10 delegates did us proud and showcased their skills. Out of this talented young group, 7 of them were declared as best delegates in their respective committees. Moving forward, over the next 2 months, our 7 delegates will be busy preparing for the Harvard MUN to be held in Beijing in March 2019. Our students have also participated in the International Kangaroo Science Contest, in which they have won 2 gold and 7 bronze medals. At the International Linguistic Contest, our students secured 4 gold and 4 bronze medals. VENICE took part in the Dance Spelling Bee competition, in which 3 of our students won the district rounds and moved on to the regionals. Our senior students have also been participating at LIGHOP every year. Our sports team are our superstars who have made their mark at numerous inter-house and inter-school matches this year, receiving accolades and awards from different tournaments. Over 30 of our students have toured Baku as part of our school's international excursion, and our annual national trip is in the pipeline. I would also like to share with you that we have passed an international inspection and VENICE has been awarded the category of being an associate member of COBIS, the Council of British International Schools. This privilege is only awarded once a school has achieved a high standard after being closely monitored for a few years and passed all internationally recognized criteria set by COBIS. I know I have taken up some of your time, but it is a proud moment for all of us to share the accomplishments of our small student body of just 190 students in the senior school. They have made us so very proud and reinforce our belief that strength does not always lie in numbers. At VENICE, we believe in quality over quantity. At our school concerts and plays, we ensure that each student is given the opportunity to participate and play a role, as it promotes confidence and teamwork. We discover so much talent when we prepare for an event like this, and we are extremely proud that as per tradition, we have ensured that each one of our senior school students has a role and performs today. Even though some of our senior students have not been as enthusiastic as they used to be, but as we know, it is equally important that these young adults also learn about teamwork and participation, even if it's not so cool. I'm extremely proud of our student body, They have displayed remarkable discipline, tenacity, and team spirit, and have worked with unwavering dedication to put together this show for you. We are also extremely grateful to all of you, our parents, for the trust and confidence that you have placed in your child's school. I would like to reassure you that our commitment towards the progress of LINCS is irrefutable. And I thank you once again. Thank you. And without taking up more of your time, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present to you our very own LINCS production, The Merchant of Venice.
Secret pilgrimage that today you promised to tell me of.
In Belmont is a lady, which she left. She is fair and fairer than the world of wondrous virtues. Sometimes from her eyes I did receive fair speechless messages. Renowned suitors and sunny locks hang on her temples like a golden fleece. Oh my Antonio, had I but the means to hold a rival place with one of them. I have a mind that presages me to such thrift that I should question less be fortunate.
Thou know that all my fortunes are at the sea, neither I have money nor quantity. Try what my creation Venice can give.
Nerissa, my little body is a weary of this great world.
You would be, sweet madam,
if your miseries were in the same abundance as your great fortunes are. And yet, for aught I see, they are as sick and suffeet, with too much as they that starve with nothing. Oh me, the virtues! I may neither choose whom I would, nor refuse whom I wouldn't. So is the will of the living daughter curbed by the will of the dead father. Is it not hard, Nerissa, that I may neither choose one nor refuse none?
Your father was a very virtuous and holy man.
There isn't any amongst them, and I dote on his very absence. I pray God grant them a fair departure.
Do you not remember, lady, during your father's time, a Venetian, a scholar, a soldier, that came hither in company of Marquis of Montferrat?
Yes, yes. It was Bassanio, as I think he was so called.
True, madam. He of all men that ever my foolish eyes looked upon was best deserving a fair lady.
I remember him well, and I remember him deserving thy praise.
Madam,
how now? What news?
The four strangers seek for you, madam, to take their leave. And there is a forerunner come from fifth, the Prince of Morocco, who brings word the prince, his master, will be here tonight.
If I could bid the fifth welcome with so good a heart as I could bid the other four farewell, I should be glad of his approach. If he has the condition of a saint, but the complexion of a devil, I rather he shrive me than wive me. Come, Nerissa, go before, whilst we shut the gates upon one wooer, another knocks at the door.
Thank you.
agrees to make a short-term loan, but in the moment of dark humor, he makes a condition. The loan must be repaid in 3 months, or Shylock will extract a pound of flesh from Antonio. Antonio agrees, confident that his ships will sail.
$3,000 ducats. Well?
Aye, sir. For 3 months.
For 3 months? Well?
For which I told you, Antonio will be bound.
Antonio shall become bound. Well?
Shall I know your answer?
Antonio is a good man.
Have you heard any imputation to the
contrary? No. My meaning in saying he is a good man is to have you understand me, that he is sufficient. Yet his means are in supposition, his ships not on the shore. I mean there are pirates and there is a peril of waters, winds, and rocks. The man is not withstanding sufficient. 3,000 ducats, I think I may have his bond.
Be assured you may.
May I speak with Antonio?
If it pleases you, dine with us.
Who is he comes here?
Senor Antonio.
How like a fawning publican he looks. I hate him, for he's a Christian. He lends me money gratis and brings down the rate of usance here with us in Venice. He hates our nation, sacred nation, and he rails. Even there where merchants must do congregate on me, my tribe, and my well-won thrift, which he calls interest. Cursed be my tribe if I forgive him.
3,000 ducats for 3 months.
Aye, 3,000 is a good round sum. 3 months from 12 now, let me see the rate.
Well, shall we be beholden to you?
Senor Antonio, you call me a misbeliever, a cutthroat dog. Spit on me Wednesday last. For these courtesies, I lend you thus much monies?
I am the son to call thee so again, to spit on thee again, to spurn thee too.
Why, look you, how you storm. I would be friends with you and have your love. Forget the shame that you have stained me with. Supply your present wants, take no dark effusions, and you will not hear me. This is kind I offer.
This were kindness.
The kindness will I show. Go with me to a notary and seal me there if you repay me not in such a day, such a place, such a sum. Be nominated for an equal pound of flesh to be cut off and taken in what part of your body pleaseth me.
Content and faith, I will seal the bond.
Should not seal to such a bond for me. I'd rather dwell in my necessity.
Should not. I will not forfeit it. Before this bond expires, I do expect return of 3 times the value of this bond.
Then meet me forthwith at the notary.
As per the terms of Portia's father's will, all suitors must choose from among 3 caskets, one which contains a portrait of her. The caskets were divided into gold, silver, and bronze, bearing the description. The first of gold, who this inscription bears, "Whoever chooseth me shall gain what many men desire." The second of silver, which this promise carries, "Who chooseth me shall get as much as he deserves." And the third, dull lead, with warning all as blunt, "Who chooseth me must give and hazard all he hath." If any one of the suitors choose the casket with the portrait, will marry Portia. The Prince of Morocco and the Prince of Aragon come to meet Portia at Belmonte.
The Prince of Morocco and his train have come to please you and meet you.
Thank you.
dislike me not for my complexion, the shadow livery of the burner's son, to whom I am a neighbor and near bred. Bring me the fairest creature northward born, where Phoebus' fire scarce thaws the icicles, and let us make incision for your love, to prove whose blood is reddest, his or mine. I tell thee, lady, this aspect of mine hath feared the valiant. By my love, I swear, the best regarded virgins of our clime would have loved it too. I would not change this hue, except to steal your thoughts, my gentle queen.
You must take your chance, and either not attempt to choose at all, or swear before you choose. If you choose wrong, never speak to lady in the way of marriage. Therefore, be advised.
Then come, bring me unto my chance.
Go, draw aside the curtains and discover the several caskets to this noble prince. Now, make your choice.
How shall I know if I do choose the right?
One of the caskets contains my picture, prince. If you choose that, then I'm yours with all.
Oh God, direct my judgment. Let me see. I will survey the inscriptions back again.
The Prince of Morocco unlocks the golden casket.
Oh hell, what have we here? A carrion death, within whose empty eye there is a written scroll. Then farewell, heat, and welcome, frost. Portia, adieu. I have too grieved a heart to take a tedious leave. Thus, losers part.
Come out of ashes. if my fortune be not crossed, I have a father and you a daughter lost. I'm sorry thou wilt leave my father so. Our house is hell, and thou, a merry devil, didst rob it of some taste of tediousness. But fare thee well, there's a ducat for thee. And, Launcelot, soon at supper shalt thou see Lorenzo, who is thy new master's guest. Give him this letter, do it secretly, and so farewell, I will not have my father see me and talk with thee.
Adieu, tears exhibit my tongue. Most beautiful pagan, most sweet Jew, if a Christian did not play the knave and get thee, I am much deceived. But adieu, these foolish drops do something drown my manly spirit. Adieu.
Farewell, good Lancelot. Alack, what heinous sin is it in me to be ashamed to be my father's child? But though I am a daughter to his blood, I am not his manners. O Lorenzo, if thou keep promise, I shall end this strife, become a Christian, and thy loving wife.
Nay, we will slink away in supper time, disguises at my lodging, and return. All in and out.
We have not made good preparations.
We have not yet spoken us about torchbearers.
It is while, unless it may be quaintly ordered, or better in my mind, not undertook.
It is now but 4 o'clock. We have 2 hours to furnish us. Friend Lancelot, what's the news?
And it shall please you to break up this. It shall seem to signify.
Another hand. In faith, it is a fair hand. And whiter than the paper it write on is the fair hand that writ.
Love news, in faith.
By your leave, sir.
Whither goest thou?
Marry, sir, to bid my old master, the Jew, to sup tonight with my new master, the Christian.
Hold here. Take this. Tell gentle Jessica I will not fail her. Speak it privately. Go, gentlemen. Will you prepare for this mask tonight? I am provided of a torchbearer.
Aye, marry. I'll be gone by it straight.
And so will I.
Meet me and Gratiano at Gratiano's lodging some hour hence.
It's good, we do so.
Was not that letter from fair Jessica?
I must needs tell thee all. She had directed how I should take her from her father's house, what gold and jewels she is furnished with, what pages suit she hath in readiness. Come, go with me. Peruse this as thou goest. Fair Jessica shall be my torchbearer.
Jessica, Jessica,
Jessica, Jessica,
well thou shalt see, thy eyes shall be thy judge, the difference of old Shylock and Bassanio. What, Jessica, thou shalt not gormandize, as thou hast done with me. What, Jessica, and sleep and snore and rend the pal. Why, Jessica, I say.
Why, Jessica.
Who bids thee call? I do not bid thee call.
Your worship was wont to tell me that. I could do nothing without bidding.
Call you? What is your will?
I'm bid for to supper, Jessica. There are my keys. But wherefore should I go? I'm not bid for love. They flatter me. But yet I'll go in hate to feed upon the prodigal Christian. Jessica, my girl, look to my house. I'm right loath to go. There's some ill a-brewing towards my rest, for I did dream of money bags tonight.
I beseech you, sir, go. My young master doth expect your reproach.
So do I his.
And they have conspired together. I will not say you shall see a mask, but if you do, then it was not for nothing that my nose fell bleeding on.
What? Are there masks? Hear you me, Jessica. Lock up my doors, nor thrust your head in the public street to gaze on Christian fools with varnished faces.
I will go before, sir. Mistress, look out at window. There will come a Christian boy. Will be worth a Jewess's eye.
What says that fool?
His words were farewell, mistress, nothing else.
Perhaps I will return immediately. Do as I bid you. Shut doors after me.
Farewell. And if my fortune be not crossed, I have a father and you a daughter lost.
This is the penthouse under which Lorenzo desired us to make stand.
His hour is almost past.
And it is marvel he outdwells his hour, for lovers ever run before the claw.
Here comes Lorenzo. More of him hereafter.
Sweet friends, your patience for my long abode. Not I, but my affairs have made you wait.
Who are you? Tell me for more certainty. I'll bet, I'll swear that I do know your tongue.
Lorenzo, and thy love?
Lorenzo, certain, and my love indeed. For who love I so much? And now who knows whether I am yours?
Heaven and thy thoughts are witness that thou art.
Here, catch this casket. It is worth the pains. I'm glad this night you do not look at me.
Descend, for you must be my torchbearer. You are sweet, even in the lovely garnish of a boy.
I will make fast the doors and gild myself with some more ducats and be with you straight.
Three things. First, never to unfold which casket was I chose. Next, if I do choose the right casket, never to woo a maid in the way of marriage. Lastly, if I do fail in fortune of my choice, immediately to leave you and be gone.
To those injunctions everyone doth swear, that comes to hazard for my worthless self. Too long a pause for what you find there, Prince.
What's here? How much unlike art thou to Portia? How much unlike my hopes and my deservings?
Thus hath the candle singed the moth. Oh, these deliberate fools, when they do choose, they have the wisdom by their wit to lose.
The ancient saying is no heresy. Hanging and wiving goes by destiny.
Come, draw aside the curtains, Larissa.
Where is my lady?
Here. What would my lord?
Madam, there is a lighted at your gate, a young Venetian, one that come before, to signify the approaching of his lord, from whom he bringeth sensible regrets, to wit besides commends and courteous breath, gifts of rich value, yet I have not seen. So lightly, an ambassador of love, a day in April never came so sweet, to show how costly summer was at hand, as this forespire comes before his lord.
No more, I pray thee. I am half afraid. Thou wilt say anon to some kin to thee, thou spend such high day wit in praising him. Come, come, Larissa, for I long to see. Could Cupid's force that comes so mannerly?
Bassanio, Lord love, if thy will it be,
I pray you tarry. Pause a day or two before you hazard in for choosing wrong, and I lose your company. Therefore, bear a while.
Let me choose, for I live upon the rack.
Upon the rack, Bassanio? Then confess what treason there is mingled in with your love.
Promise me, life. I'll confess the truth.
Well, confess and live.
Confess and love.
I'm locked in one of them. If you love me, you will find me out.
You that choose, not by the view, chance as fair, and choose as true. Since this fortune falls on you, be content and seek no new. Turn where your lady is.
You see me, Lord Bassanio, where I stand, such as I am, happiest of all. Myself and what is mine is now yours and converted. Of this mansion, master to my servants, this house and myself are now yours, my lord.
When this ring parts from this finger, then parts life from hence. Or then be bold to say, Bassanio's dead.
My lord and lady, it is now our time.
My lord and my gentle lady, I wish you the joy that you can wish for I am sure you can wish none from me.
With all my heart, so thou can get a wife.
I thank your lordship you have got me one. You saw the mistress, I beheld the maid.
Is that true?
Madam, it is so.
And you, Gratiano, mean good faith?
Yes, faith, my lord.
Our feet shall be much honored in your marriage.
Who comes here? Lorenzo and his Jessica?
Lorenzo and Salerio, welcome hither. I bid my worthy friends, countrymen, and sweet Jessica, welcome.
So do I, my lord. There are some shrewd contents in your letter that steal the color away from Bassanio's cheeks. Is some dear friend in trouble, some dear friend dead, what worse than worse?
Sweet Bassanio, my ships have all miscarried. My creditors grow cruel. My estate is very low. My bond to the Jew is forfeit. And since in paying it, it is impossible I shall live. All debts are cleared between you and me. If I might but see you at my death.
The dearest friend to me, the kindest man, the best condition, and unready spirit in doing courtesies.
What sum owes he the Jew?
For me, 3,000 ducats.
What? No more? Pay him 6,000 and deface the bond. O love, dispatch all businesses and be gone.
Since I have a good leave to go away, I will make haste. But till I come again, no bed shall be guilty of my stay.
The world thinks, and I think so too, that you demand fulfillment of your contract out of malice. It is thought you will press until the last moment and then show mercy. How can the flesh of Antonio help you? We all expect a gentle answer, Jew.
I possess your grace for what I propose, and by a holy Sabbath have I sworn the due and forfeit of my bond. If you deny it, let the danger light upon your charter and your city's freedom.
This is no answer, thou unfeeling man, to excuse the courage of thy cruelty.
I am not bound to please thee with my answers.
Do all men kill the things they do not love? For 3,000 ducats. Here, take 6.
If every ducat in 6,000 were in 6 parts, and every part a ducat, I would not draw them. I would have my bond.
Upon my power, I may dismiss this court, unless Bellario, a learned doctor, whom I have sent for to determine this, come here today.
Portia arrives in her disguise, ready to defend Antonio, given the authority of judgment by the Duke. Portia orders that Shylock can have a pound of flesh, so long as he does not draw blood, as it is against the law to shed Christian blood. Since it is obvious that to extract a pound of flesh from Antonio would kill him, Shylock is denied all his suits, moreover for conspiring to murder a Venetian citizen. Portia orders that Shylock should forfeit all his wealth, half to go to Venice and half to go to Antonio.
And here I take it is the doctor come. Give me your hand. Came you from old Bellario?
I did, my lord.
You are welcome, take your place.
Is your name Shylock?
Shylock is my name.
You stand within danger, do you not, Antonio?
Aye.
Do you confess the bond?
I do.
Then the Jew must be merciful.
Oh, what compulsion must I? Tell me that.
The quality of mercy is not stayed. It droppeth as gentle rains from the heavens. It bless him for what he takes and gives. I have spoken enough.
My teeth upon my head, I crave the law, the penalty, and forfeit of my bond.
There is no law in Venice that can alter a decree established.
But Daniel, come to judgment.
I pray you, let me look upon the bond.
Here is this, most reverend doctor. Here it is.
A pound of flesh to be cut by nearest the merchant's heart. Be merciful, take thrice the amount and let me tear this bond.
There is no power in the tongue of man to order me.
I do beseech the court to give the judgment.
You must prepare your chest for his knife.
Oh, noble judge. Oh, excellent young man.
Have some surgeon, Shylock, on your charge to his wounds, lest he do bleed to death.
Is it so nominated in the bond? I cannot find it is not in the bond.
Be little. I am armed and well prepared. Give me your hand, Bassanio, and fare you well.
Antonio, I am married to a wife which is as dear to me as life itself. But life itself, my wife, and all the world are not with me, esteemed above thy life.
Your wife would give you little thanks for that.
Most learned judge, a sentence come, prepare.
Danny, wait, a little, there is something else. Does bond God give thee no drop of blood? The words expressly are a pound of flesh, but in cutting it, if thou dost shed one drop of Christian blood, all your goods and land should be confiscated by the laws of Venice.
Oh, upright judge, is that the law?
Yes, justice be assured.
I take this offer. Pay the bond thrice and let the Christian go.
Here is the money.
Soft. The Jew shall have all justice. Soft. No haste. You can take a pound of flesh, but if the scale do turn, then thy goods confiscated.
A second Daniel. A Daniel, Jew.
Take thy forfeiture.
Give my principal and let me go.
But you refused it in open court.
Shall I not have barely my principle.
Thou shalt have nothing but forfeiture.
Thou shalt see the difference of our spirit. I pardon thee, thy life, before thou ask it. For half of thy wealth it is Antonio's, and the other half for the state.
What mercy can you render him, Antonio?
Antonio gives his half back to Shylock on the condition that Shylock bequeaths it to his disinherited daughter, Jessica. Shylock must also convert to Christianity. A broken Shylock accepts.
So please, my lord, he presently becomes Christian, and upon his death, all his lands and goods will be possessed to his son-in-law and daughter, Lorenzo and Jessica.
I am content.
Clerk, draw thee the gift.
Give me leave, for hence I am not well. Send the deed after me, and I will sign it.
Get thee gone, but do it.
Sir, I entreat you home with me to dinner.
I humbly do desire your grace of pardon, but I must leave.
I am sorry that your leisure serves you not. Antonio, gratify these gentlemen, for you are bound to.
Most worthy gentlemen, I and my friend would like to offer you 3,000 ducats.
Thank you, but my mind was never yet set on mercenary.
Yes,
know me once you meet again. I must leave.
Dear sir, I must attempt to further. Take something of us as a tribute.
You press me far. Well then, give me that ring. I'll take it as a remembrance of you.
This ring? It's a trifle. I will not shame myself to give you this.
I would have nothing but this.
There's more depends on this than the value. I pray you, pardon me.
I see. You taught me how to beg, and now you think you answer how a beggar should be answered.
My lord Sanyo, let him have the ring.
Go, Graciano. Run, overtake him, and give him the ring.
Fair sir, my lord Bassanio has sent you this ring.
I pray no more, this ring, thankfully.
In such a night did pretty Jessica slander her love.
I would outnight you did nobody come. But hard, I hear the footing of a man.
Paltry ring that she did give me.
You swore to me, when you did give it to me, that you would wear it till your hour of death.
I gave it to a youth, a kind of boy, a little scrub boy.
You are to blame. I must be plain with you. I gave my love a ring and made him swear never to part with it. and here he stands. Gratiano, you give your wife a too unkind cause for grief.
Why, I would best to cut my left hand off and swear I love the ring defending it.
My lord Bassanio gave his ring to the judge.
If I could add a lie unto a fault, I would deny it. But you see, my finger has not the ring upon it.
Why would you give it, my lord? Even so, void is your false heart of truth. By heaven, I will never look at you until I see that ring.
Nor I at you till I again see mine.
I am the unhappy subject of these quarrels.
Sir, you are not a part of this, notwithstanding.
I once did lend my body for his wealth, my soul upon the forfeit, that your lord will evermore break faith.
Then you shall be his surety.
By heaven, it is the same ring.
I had it of him.
And pardon me, my gentle Graciano.
You are all amazed.
Were you the doctor and I knew you not?
Aye. Here is the letter that comes from old Bellario, and it states that in court, Portia was the doctor, Nerissa the clerk. Antonio, we have some unexpected news for you as well.
My lady, you have given me life and living, for here I read for certain that my ships are safely come to harbour.
How now, Lorenzo? There are some good comforts for you too.
I, given without a fee, there to I give to you and Jessica a special dear gift. All of his lands and goods will be yours.
Fair ladies, you drop manna in the way of starved people.
It is almost morning, and we are sure you are not yet satisfied with these events at full. Let us go in and answer all things faithfully.
Let us fear nothing so sore as keeping safe our lady's rings.
Thus, dear friends, we do learn that greed inspires men to expect more than they earn. He that has love needeth not more. The gluttonous with material things does keep score.
Wonderful. It gives me great pleasure to call on stage our staff for the grand finale. Saif Salman, Bassanio, and Ayla Adnan as Portia. Oh.
Vanessa. Daniel Valika Salerio, Aryan Parvani Salanio, Amiruddin Sheikh Lenslop, and the Prince of Aragon, Reza Malwala. Our narrator, Mohammed Rayan Habib. Our narrator and singers, Miral Hai and Maggie Smith. Rohan Khan, Mozam Parar, and Dao Chakrani. The Duke of Venice, Rahim Tarpur, his jury, Mehak Vazir, Fatma Hanif, Saif Abbasi, Mazik Chandio, and Alisha Nozaki. Sari, Anand Shah, and Maryam Khan. And put your hands together for the choir. The class five, the merchant dancers. Behind are some more merchant dancers. The boys from class 5, well done. Classes 7 and 8, the Moroccan dancers. Some more. Come on up, the Moroccan dancers. The boys of class 7 and 8. We have the mass dancers, the girls and boys from class 8, 9 and 10. Marjan Kamal, Fawzi Abbasi, Nisha Salman, Anusha Kamran, Irid Zuberi, Iman Jalal, Jibran Magdoon, Maha Majid, Maheen Sethi, Ahmed Faisal, Alhira Ahmed, Hamoud Khalid, Ilhan Jatoi, and Maha Ahmed. All the decor, all the props, they did a great job. Well done. And I'm going to take up a little bit of your time now, and I hope you've enjoyed our school concert. You have been a good audience, but the real credit and thanks goes to these children up here. Boys and girls, thank you. You have given us the chance to witness the power and magic of drama. The performance we experienced today was not a chance outcome. They have worked very hard, and you have shown how professional you can be after countless hours of practice and rehearsal, and after countless calling from all of us too. Yeah, the magic was not created just by those fancy props and gorgeous costumes, but your performance, confidence, creativity, and tenacity. Taking on and performing such an ambitious and complex script like The Merchant of Venice has been commendable. Thank you. It would be amiss if I don't thank a few people that made today's performance possible. As you can imagine, coordinating over 190 students is a huge task. So much to do: choreography, music coordination, costumes, designing, set, direction. And so it's a collective effort that cannot be done by any one
individual, and I'd like to thank and I'd request you all to put your hands together for our wonderful teachers. Thank you. And amongst the school of wonderful teachers, there are a few special mentions as always. Miss Sabine, thank you. From the word go, all your hard work, dedication, that can you please come up in front, Miss Sabine? Miss Hilla, all your coordination, ensuring that they don't miss too many classes, even though they wanted to. Miss Hilla, please come up in front. For set designing, Jessica and Ajaz, thank you. Let Jessica step in all the time, everywhere. Please, big hand. For direction and coordination, please come on out as I call your names. Aliza Zaidi, Murtaza Jafri, Sanya Hakani, and Ms. Kamal Bacha. Please come on out. Give them a big hand. They've been working tirelessly. Backstage coordinators, Nadir Khan, Mariam Khan, and Ms. Marish Rizvi. Please come out and take a bow. Our choreographers. Okay, let them come out. Nadir is missing. Okay, our choreographers. Ms. Mani Nadeem, Zara Asif, and Maya Tarapur. Thank you. I would like to say a very, very big thank you to our admin staff, Harish, Shakir, Johnson, all our domestic staff. They have been working round the clock, especially with that rain that threw us all off course. I think they've been working 24 hours, round the clock. Thank you. As always, you're our backbone. We cannot do this without you. I'd like to acknowledge and thank a few parents. As always, Mr. and Mrs. Munaf. When I thank them, they say, it's our school, don't thank us. But thank you. It is supportive parents like you that give us a lot of hope and encouragement. Miss Amna Tokir, you saved the day. And you know how. Thank you. Miss Sonia Khan and Mr. Salman Iqbal, for sounds and lights, we couldn't have done this without them. Not bitten by mosquitoes today. Thank you, Mr. Bilal Jaffer. Thank you. He's very efficiently fumigates the whole place. Makeup and backstage, Ms. Amar Shah, Shaila Gokal, Maryn Rahman, and Ms. Rabia Hai. Thank you as always. From everyone at Links, good night and God bless. Thank you. For sound, the lovely choir, Ms. Angela, Mr. George David, and Ms. Afshin Mohsin. Apologies, they have been here day in and day out. Thank you, teachers. Thank you, everyone.